Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hey fish family, welcome back to Tabatic Aquatics. My name is Ross, the name of the channel is Tabatic Aquatics, and you're my fish run. Alright, real quick, those of you who have been following my channel, you know already that I love to keep a lot of different species of fish, but I typically don't keep the everyday run-of-the-mill fish. I like showstoppers, I like to wow you. You know how people have centipede fish? I usually have a centipede tank because every fish in the tank is could be a centipede fish. Well, in any case, tonight what we're going to do is get into the Pinktail Chalceus, and that's right after my intro, so hold tight. Fish family, we are in my tank, one of my tanks, and we're taking a look at my Pinktail Chalceus. I wanted to do a video spotlight on these guys, or highlighting these guys, because I personally feel like they are one of the most underrated aquarium fish that we keep. I don't see a lot of these fish on people's in their tanks, on their YouTube channels or anything. People don't speak of these fish a lot, but they're very underrated as far as I'm concerned. Look at how pink and beautiful his tail is, you know, and they got the little pink splotches on the side of their body against that silver. This is awesome. So if you're looking for some color or something different in your tank, you might want to consider these guys, because you know you'll be hard pressed to find fish that have that hot pink fuchsia type of color that to add to your tank. And you see them with their mood changes, how their pink, their tail will go from light to very dark and intense according to how they feeling, or if they about to dart across, or you know, if they feeling, you know, very confident or not. I love it. Look how his tail is just getting more and more intense when he interact with me, really, because believe it or not, they're interacting with this camera because they know that I'm here and they like to show off, and they probably think I'm about to feed them. Okay, speaking about feed them, their diet, very meaty diet. They love high protein meaty foods, so you want to put in foods, pellets and freeze-dried krill, bloodworms, freeze-dried mealworms, you know, stuff like that, crickets. Very meaty food. You can chop up some frozen prawn and frozen pieces of fish and so forth, but put them in, when you do that, put them in little at a time, because if the food sinks down to the bottom, these pinktail chalceus will not go down and get it. They're hunters, they're predators. They will not eat from the bottom. They like to eat their food up at the top, and that's why I put in slow sinking pellets and flakes and so forth like that. But they love the freeze-dried mealworms and freeze-dried prawn. All right, that's how you're going to feed them. Let's talk about tank mates. What you want to do is, first of all, most people will tell you either keep one of these species or keep six or more, because they are very feisty. They will chase each other around and do some fin nipping and stuff like that. I chose to only get four of them, and I took a chance, but I did get them when they were very small and they all grew up together. These same four I've had since they were about an inch and a half long. I bought them all together, and they've grown up together. And as you can see, they're pretty peaceful with each other. They don't, their fins, none of them have any torn fins and, you know, anything like that. Now, as far as their tank mates, you see I have them in here with the albino heckli, or albino thread fin acara, but they just albino heckli. As you can see, that they got nice trailers on them. In other words, what I'm showing you is that these pinktail chalceus do not go and nip at their fins and bother them at all. I have them in here with Gorda River rainbow fish, And I have some Cernomyces geophagus and some blue Pinoy angelfish in here. At the bottom, I keep plecos and clown loaches at the bottom, and a few quarry cats as well. So peaceful to semi-aggressive fish, you can keep them with. Now, if you keep them with predator fish, they will they're very fast. They torpedo-like. They will evade, get caught and eaten by, you know, for the most part. But they'll be stressed out like hell. Okay, so don't put them in there with very aggressive fish like jaguars, cichlids, and so forth. Just make sure it's like a semi-aggressive tank. They do well like that. All right. Now, water conditions. How to care for them? What you want to do is keep in mind that they like their pH between 6.0 to 7.5. A good comfortable pH for them is 7.0 to 7.3. They do come from South America, the northern part of South America, so they can do good and tolerate with soft water, just not too soft and definitely not too hard, okay? As far as temperature is, you're going to keep their temperature somewhere between 72 and 82 degrees. I keep a comfortable temperature in all of my tanks, or most of them anyway, at about 77 to 78 degrees. And they do just fine with that. And they will live their lifespan in your tank, if well taken care of, about 15 years. They usually grow 10 to 12 inches in the wild, but in your tank you can expect 8 to 10 inches. Make sure you have at least a 6-foot tank so that they can stretch out and swim around, because as you can see, they stay busy, they stay moving. They don't hide behind, you know, ornaments and stuff like that. They love space, they love to move. And you see that flow, I keep a good flow. So they're gonna need more than just a canister filter as far as oxygenation. They use up a lot of oxygen. So make sure you have a wave maker in your tank, creating a high flow for them guys, and they will appreciate that, okay? Don't leave the light on in your tank all day, real bright and all that stuff, because they don't like bright lights on them for too long at a time. They appreciate like a medium level light to low level light, okay? I just keep this light on long enough for me to see what's going on in here. I feed them and film this video. And then I cut it off and let the ceiling light be enough light for this tank right here. All right, y'all, I'm not gonna talk y'all to death. I'm not saying that I haven't already, but I just wanted to highlight these fish because I feel like they're underestimated. They occupy the top of the tank. If you're looking for something, they occupy the top of the tank and keep some busyness and some balance in your tank. They are excellent. They're excellent for dither fish because they move a lot and they make the other fish comfortable to come out and be active as well. All right. So, yeah, I think you should check into it. You know, y'all can leave a comment. Let me know what you think about them. But I love them. I'm happy I got them. I'm very pleased with them. Well, until the next time, y'all. Happy fish keeping. All right, well, family, that video there was a long time coming. Long time coming. Should have been did that one. But I'm glad that we did get around to it. Well, in any case, thank you very much for staying by and watching my video. To those of you, if this is your first time to my channel, please consider subscribing to my channel. Please, if you don't want to subscribe, I understand, but it is free of charge, okay? It don't cost you anything to subscribe, and you can unsubscribe at any time, but I promise you, if you subscribe, you will likely stay with me, okay? Thank you for taking this ride with me. Go ahead and also leave a like, leave a comment, let me know what you think, give me any suggestions that you may have. Of course, we're going to treat it respectful, because other people are viewing your comments, so we want to, you know, if you don't like me, at least respect the other people who are viewing these comments or whatever. And those of you who have already subscribed and been supporting me, I thank you deeply from the bottom of my heart. I'm taking precious time because I'm extremely busy. I work like crazy, and I'm really stealing time away from my family and from my sleep in order to film these videos. Well, in any case, I'm not going to keep it too long. Like I said, please support my channel by subscribing, sharing, leave a like, you know, leave a comment. Let's have some dialogue. And until next time, happy fish keeping. Assalamu alaikum. Wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.